Johnny, what's your plan?
I don't want to do mine.
You've got to do yours.
No, I don't want to do it. I tried a bit too hard.
You're among friends, Johnny. Come on, do us your poem. Don't be shy.
Oh, no, it's going to be dead embarrassing.
No,
now.
Come on.
It's really long, man. it's not all of them. It's not all of them. It's a page.
OK.
I apologise.
Johnny Vegas, everyone.
In advance.
Don't apologise. No. Commit to the poem. Right, commit to it, Johnny.
OK, all right, all right. It's about last orders. Ask not for whom that bell doth toll as wordy barmaid's eyes do roll. A landlord with an earnest shout calls time on drinks and ushers out. The dutiful sup up and leave, but he's a last card up his sleeve. With feet like landlocked deep-sea diver, shuffles barwards with a fiver. He begs the lass for just one more, and one yourself just make it right. He promises to drink it quick, yet deep down knows he's feeling sick. Not from stout or bags of scratchings, more from questions booze keeps asking. What happened to the happy me? I think, no hang on, need to pee. In the bog the poet sways, poised to ponder fonder days. Before the time of cheap warm cider, eyes of wonder opening wider. Now they narrow, tired of fun, as fart turns wet and burns the bum. Yet Rory smile pops in his head, till urine runs down inside leg. And thus the landlord shows him out, the child inside is crying out. I was not meant for such sweet sorrow, but opts instead for see you tomorrow. Thou stout, soaked, sig-stained, feckless soul is what for, not whom, that bell did toll.
Oh. I mean, come on. I think we have a winner. Come on. That was heartbreaking.
It was about a friend.
I've got some poems, if you want me to read a poem.
Sounds good.
OK, so I've got a poem about... do you want one about a witch, a poem about love, or a poem about cubs?
Witch.
Witch. So this is a poem about the witches, I guess. A witch frigged herself off with her broom handle.
That's not on the syllabus, is it?
A witch frigged herself off with her broom handle. Her cat watched on, tired of it all. I'm published. Published poet.
Is it harder to make them rhyme? I thought poems rhymed.
I've never made one rhyme.
You're not?
No.
Is it on purpose, or could you not?
No, I've tried. What I do is I sit down for an hour trying to make one rhyme, and then I can't do it, so then I write that sort of thing.
You could have had, like, wigged, bigged, digged.
You're going to need a rhyme for splinter for verse two.
Nick, what have you got for us?
I've got a poem.
You've got a poem? Well, fantastic.
What is that? I have feelings I can share.
That says stalking and stalker on the back page. Yeah, it did.
Here is a poem that is simply called Busy Bee. Busy bee, busy bee, why are you so busy? Busy bee, busy bee, always in a tizzy. Busy bee, busy bee, thank you for the honey. Busy bee, busy bee, I owe you more than money. Busy bee, I hope it never ends. Busy bee, you are my only friend. That was about a bee I made friends with on a family holiday in Uruguay. I called him a race, he was a legend.
It's a bee just landed on your arm, as they said that. Paul Jarmo! There he is!
It's a fly!
Busy bee!
You're not a race! And I've got another poem. This one's called Butterfly.
I don't fancy your chances, mate.
You wouldn't do that during Shakespeare, would you?
You have got the beard.
Oh, come on, mate. Just let me do my poem and get through it. Then you can carry on with the game. I've got a poem for Susie.
Sorry, Nick.
Shut the fuck up! No, where was I? Swoop, swoop, goes the net, but the butterfly, it flits, idly avoiding the meshed cage of love. Swoop, swoop, goes the net, but the butterfly, it flits, resting and nesting in the flowers of the adjoining field. Swoop again! Again! And swoop thrice more. But the butterfly, it flits, and my love goes unanswered. Why, butterfly, why? Why must you flit? But the butterfly does not answer, for it has no mouth.
And then I've written a poem using the words going across with the letters starting the words.
So shit yourself when you got to that W, didn't you? Someone was overconfident with the CL.
Yeah. I thought it was amazing.
Yeah. Only on Countdown could you hear the phrase, you shit yourself when you got to that W.
I'm dying to hear this now. Go on.
So... Yeah, but also it's a haiku as well, so it means that the first line has got 5 syllables, then the second one 7, and the third one 5. And the theme is Countdown. And because of all of those restrictions, it's shit. OK, consonants useful. I missed the O.
What have you got for us?
Well, I was going to just pick a poem out of my poetry book and then just read your poem.
That sounds good, OK. Just at random?
Just randomly. Oh, this one will do. Everything was wonderful. Everything was great. Everything was perfect. Then it turned to hate. The clouds, they started forming. Now she doesn't take my calls. She pretends that nothing happened, that she's better than it all. Well, sorry, I'm still breathing. Excuse me for sitting here. Didn't realise my presence would cause you such a stir. Am I just a piece of used meat, chewed up and spat out in the cold, sitting here beside me, judging? And that is a poem called Sitting Next to the One That Broke My Heart on Countdown.
My poem's about something very important to me. It's about how come it's OK to name you Willie, but it's not OK to name the fellas Willie next to you at the urinals. So my poem's called Hanging About in a Train Station Toilet Naming People's Penises. Hello, commuter, on your way to work. I'm going to call yours Captain Birdseye. Because it looks like it's wearing a polar neck and winking at me. I just named your penis. Hello, Hello, train driver who just nipped in for a piss. I'm going to call yours Mrs. Fernsby. My old geography teacher. Because you're small and wrinkly and have a birthmark down the side of your shaft. You're welcome. I just named your penis. Hello, please. Hello,
please. Stop.
Hello. Hello, police officer. Who's that? Hello, police officer who's just been sent to the toilets because they've had reports of someone naming people. You can't arrest me for naming strangers cocks. Oh, you can. I didn't know that. Oh, great. Now I'm electronically tagged again.
Tim, you're known for your poetry. Are there any words that are particularly good or bad for poetry?
I sort of tend to avoid sort of long ones or flowery words or words where I have to think of the word. So I'll just use... I suppose I'll just use any old word.
OK.